Hello everyone, my name is Abby Bliss White and welcome to my channel. Today we are going to do a little get ready with me. I am playing with some new makeup as well as some oldies but goodies. I did have a request to pick up some of the new Orgasm X collection, and so I've got a few pieces of those that we'll be putting on my face, as well as a new bronzer. This is the Ilia bronzer that I've been wanting to check out, so we're going to be putting this guy on my face as well as some of the Orgasm X collection. I'll let you know my thoughts on these products. So if you are interested in seeing how I got this look, then let's go ahead and get started. Okay, we are going to be playing with some oldies and some new stuff. And because I picked up some of the new NARS Orgasm collection, I decided to pull out an oldie but goodie. And this is the NARS Pure Radiant Tinted Moisturizer. I wore this for years and years and years. I kind of think this is a little bit too old to be using, but we'll just pull it out. I am in shade number Light 3 Growing Land, and that is this shade here. And who remembers the little compact? My favorite foundation for so many years was the NARS, and it was in the compact. It was the cream. I just loved that one so much. And then they phased that out, and then I did not like the newer version of their cream. So let's pull this guy out. I just remember just kind of liking to wear this by dabbing this into the skin and with using a little sponge to kind of tap this in. Okay, that's just gonna give me a little bit of a nice little tint, and then I will go in with the classic. This is the NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer. Again, used this for years and years. And I'm in the shade Vanilla. Just gonna put some of this, and I'm gonna highlight a little bit. It looks like this is a dead soldier. Time to say goodbye. I remember loving the combination because this one's kind of light and radiant, and then the NARS Creamy Concealer definitely has more coverage. There is a reason why it is a classic, and I think it is because it's going to give you that coverage without being too drying. And okay, so we used these guys for our complexion, just kind of evened it out. And then I did pick up the new Ilia, and this is their Night Light Bronzing Powder. Now, I picked it up in Drawn In, and this said light to medium, but I'm going to be honest, we swatched it last night and it was a little bit light. Let's see. We're gonna see if this actually shows up on the skin. So here is this. I love the Ilia brand, so I was attracted to this. It's clearly bronzer time. So this is a matte bronzer. So Ilia is a clean brand, and this is going to give you a skin-like appearance. It's talc-free, and it says buttery soft texture blends easily and can build from a natural sun-kissed glow to a more dramatic payoff. So let's try that and see how this goes. There we go. Okay, last night the lighting definitely. Okay, you guys, it's highly pigmented, clearly. Don't worry, we'll buff that into the skin. I probably put a little bit too much on my brush. So So here is this color drawn in. And again, this is a matte kind of bronzer and it's just gonna kind of sink in. Now on this side, I went a little heavy-handed to start with. So just ignore that. But I just wanted to show you this color and I consider my skin to be light medium. And it has a really nice mirror in here. Okay, I'm gonna just powder down just a little bit with the Sisley, and this is the loose powder, and we're gonna kind of blend a little bit of that out. Now I do have a funny story. One of my favorite NARS products is their Liquid Laguna Bronzer. It's just my absolute favorite, but oh my gosh, it spilled all over my drawer. Somehow the cap got a little bit loose, so I literally had to throw this away, but it is just the best liquid bronzer out there. Love it so much, but so sad because you guys, this is a huge, colossal bronzer mess in my drawer. It got over all sorts of makeup. But anyways, that is one of my favorites. I'm gonna try to link it below because if you are someone who loves liquid bronzer, the NARS Liquid Laguna is still my favorite. But I was intrigued by this Elia. So you guys can let me know what you think about that. We're bronzing up the skin. The Mother's Day weekend, my daughter had convinced me that I must try this new orgasm palette. We used to have orgasm blush. I love, again, the liquid orgasm is one of my favorites, but we don't have it in the powder. So it comes with kind of cute packaging. It has each like a little rubber band, kind of like a tied up kind of theme. Not sure how I feel about that, but I'm not your typical orgasm girl over here. And then it comes with this guy. This is what it looks like. And so it comes with your orgasm blush, just the classic, and then this is orgasm X. That looks awfully bright to me. And then we've got this orgasm highlighter. So let me give you a little swatch. Ooh, they're really nice and creamy. Ooh, and then we've got classic, this is orgasm, and then we've got this really bright poppy orgasm X. I'm a little bit scared, but maybe we should try some on. Let's go ahead. Okay. I admit I'm a little bit intimidated by this. We're gonna start with orgasm, which I know I do like, and I haven't worn the powder version in many years. I've really loved the liquid. And so I'm just gonna start with putting that on. It's supposed to be like your universal kind of peachy pink color. And then I'm not exactly sure, we're gonna try a little bit of this pop, okay? This is that orgasm X, so we're definitely getting, I can't decide if I want it closer to the apples or just kind of spreading it out. Definitely a pretty like pop of color. And I do love a fresh, healthy flush, but that's a little bit bright. Ooh, I'm not sure how my makeup's gonna turn out today. Then I'm gonna go ahead and take a little bit of this pretty highlighter here. It looks really glowy. Ooh. Okay, you guys, this is pretty intense, just like the name implies. Okay, guys, this is like a very intense little highlighter. This might be going to Zoe. She's the one who wanted it. not exactly my cup of tea. I just don't know if she's gonna like this color. You guys, it is beautiful, but it's just a little bit strong. So I'm just think that maybe on my more pale skin, might be a little overpowering. But we're gonna blend everything in. Let's just let that sink in. And again, you guys, I do like highlighter, but that's just for me, feels a little bit kind of blingy, personal. That's personal. Now, I did pick up the Orgasm Quad. Now this one I was intrigued by because Mandy Davis, MUA, she had done a little video using this and had previously showed it to me and said how pretty it was. So I was like, let me check this out. So the NARS shadows in the last couple years have just really become so creamy and amazing. And let's check out this prettiness. This just looked like it would be kind of a soft, pretty eye, right up my alley's quad. Did I need it? Most likely not, but for the sake of YouTube, I think we should try it out. So I'm gonna take this matte shade here, and this is what that color looks like. We are gonna come and look at that in the crease, and I am going to, using refer number 16, and I'm just gonna come up into, create a little crease here. Now I am trying to go just a little bit higher than I normally do. So I'm keeping my eyes open and then just kind of bringing it up, looking straight ahead. And that's that wash of color there. And then this is the color that kind of got me. I think that is just so pretty, kind of a soft bronzy shade. And so I'm going to place, it's really creamy. I'm going to place a little bit of this bronzy goodness right on the lid. These shadows are coming on just like butter, so pretty. So love this color right here. And then I'm gonna take a little bit of that light pink and I'm gonna put that kind of in the center right over here. Just right above that pupil area. I'm gonna take that light pink and I'm gonna kind of put it in the inner part and bring it right to kind of the middle. Taking a fluffy brush here and I'm just gonna soften everything. Going back in with this matte color here and I'm just gonna come kind of deepen the crease a little bit. And with this little bit of gold here, I'm just gonna put a little bit of that up on the top of the brow bone. I'm gonna take the refer, and this is in number 3, and it's more of their pencil, and I'm just gonna go into this matte shade here. And I'm going to kind of run a little bit close to the lash line down here. Then I am going to take my Shanta Kai eyeliner in Slate, and I'm going to define my eyes just a little bit close to the lash line using a little bit of Slate. Okay guys, I have put on a little bit of eyeliner and here is that eyeshadow. One thing I am wanting to do is I think I'm gonna take a little bit of my bronzer and I'm gonna add that for a little bit of depth in my crease. So I'm gonna take a little bit of this guy. I like to do that in general, but I just wanna deepen that just a little bit. Since there is three kind of very shimmery shades in there, I want to just ground this a little bit for my particular more mature eyes. Okay guys, now it's a little bit more grounded. I'm gonna go put on mascara and then we will finish off the look. Okay, here is the finished eye look. So this is a really beautiful little palette. I do feel like I have something similar in my collection. I do love the shadow here. And the shadows are super creamy and buttery, definitely more on the shimmery side. So for me, definitely more on the shimmery side. You get three of those beautiful shimmers with just one matte. But if you don't have anything like this in your collection, I would say super pretty. This is just giving me kind of vibes of like having a suntan, wearing a sundress, and then just throwing on a little bit of this, and it would be kind of that little lovely sun goddess look. So that one, very pretty. So my thoughts on this little palette is that this is not something I'm most likely going to gravitate towards. I do love the shade Orgasm, but I love it in the liquid. I just think it looks beautiful on the skin and it melts right in. This is not that I don't think this is pretty, but I don't see myself really reaching for this coral pop. And then this highlighter right here is just a little bit too blingy for myself. So I just feel like it's emphasizing little pores that I didn't even know I had. So let me bring you in here. Right here, you guys, I'm just feeling like you can see little dots. So just, this isn't my personal kind of highlighter. So this is most likely going to go to Zoe. She was the one who kind of was wanting this in the first place. She's younger. She loves that kind of highlighter. Probably just not the best for me. Okay, last little piece that I did buy was the oil infused, and this is their lip tint. And this did look really pretty. And again, I'm thinking of if you had a lovely suntan and you're wearing a little sundress and you just wanted some kind of nice little shiny lips, this might be perfect. So here is the color. And again, super pretty. I have not tried any of these lip oils. And okay, got a little bit of pucker on there. That definitely is, again, going to give you kind of that suntan kind of glow. Pretty color here. Here's this color, and it is an Orgasm X. Definitely feel like that gives a little bit of a lift to the complexion. A little bit metallic-y. Definitely has that kind of summer vibe going on. Okay, that concludes the look of the day, using some oldies but goodies as well as some of the new Orgasm X collection. Let me know if you picked up any of those pieces, if you're planning on it. Definitely think that that eye quad is very pretty if you don't have something similar like that in your collection. And this is a really pretty kind of poppy spring summer color in this Orgasm lip oil tint. Have not tried those before, so glad to give that a try. Okay guys, that is the look for the day. I hope you guys are having a fantastic day, and I will be back with another video soon.